how to understand promises in JavaScript. In this video, I will use an easy analogy to explain them, and I will present the correct terminology so we can talk about them in the future videos. Hi, and welcome. My name is Ren Pokorny, and I like to write JavaScript. I also like to read JavaScript, and I like to talk JavaScript. And in my weekly videos, I share the best practices, I review code, or I explain the language concepts just like today. So if you are new, consider subscribing. I really like what Promises did in the JavaScript world, and they enable for so many things. They simplify so many constructs, and I really like them. They are also now widely supported, and there are so many built-in functions that return them, or you can, so many libraries even use them. I would like to talk about them much more, and for that I realized that I have to create this video when I explain them so everybody is on the same page, on the same level, has the same understanding, and very importantly, has the same terminology, because I found out that many people use the terminology kind of wrong. I will be using an easy analogy with a phone call. When you make a phone call, you first dial the number and then you go dialing and you dial. And then two things can happen. Either you don't make the call because the recipient can be reached, or you reach the recipient and you ask them about some information. So what does it mean in terms of promises? We can say that a promise is a package for parallel asynchronous execution of some code. And then reacting when either that execution finishes or it fails. Just like when I'm dialing, I can do other stuff. I can read a magazine, I can brush my teeth, or I can make a second phone call. The important thing is that by doing that, when the code is executing, you can be doing other stuff in parallel to that. In the world of promises, we call that the promise is in the pending state. As I said, after dialing, one of two things can happen. Either the phone call somehow fails, I do not reach the recipient, and that's because maybe the line is engaged, or I don't have reception, or maybe I don't have money on my SIM card, whatever that can be, I cannot reach that. And I get this information why the problem is occurring. Or, on the other hand, I reach the recipient and I get the information from them. This is the only transition that ever happens. I never get from having an error message to be immediately connected to the person I'm calling, or the other way around. Once I get an error or once I get a callee, that's where it stays. It doesn't move from there. And that's exactly the same for promises. So from that pending state, it can either go to the state of being rejected, and I have a reason why that promise was rejected, or I can go to the fulfilled state and I get value, the information I originally asked for. So we have these three states, nothing more, and these two transitions, nothing more. It's one of the simplest finite state machines you can ever see. We have one entry state and two final states, and each final state holds some piece of information. Sometimes when you want to say that a promise is not pending, that the transition has already happened, that it is either rejected or fulfilled, we call that promise to be settled. Sometimes, and this is some confusion, people call settled resolved. So when they say resolved, they mean it's settled. But some other people, when they say resolved, they mean just fulfilled. So it means not rejected, but fulfilled. And I can tell you, sometimes when I watch a presentation or a video, I don't know which one of these the speaker has in mind when they say resolved. So I would recommend, and that's how I will be doing that, to stick with this, to stop using resolved in the communication unless it's absolutely needed, because there are some methods which has this in the name. But other than that, when we talk about the state of the promise, we will avoid using that resolved word. What we have to say is that how that translates to code. Imagine we have a promise. I will call it a promise one, because we will not cover how you can create a promise. There are some ways, and we will have different videos about that, or which methods return promises, and there are some of them, and in Node and in DOM. So we have that promise, And what makes it a promise is that it has this then method. And as you can hear, then means that you react on that transition we talked about. And it has two arguments, two callbacks. The first argument, the first callback, is sometimes referred to as onFulfillment. And it's a function that gets called when the transition happens and it is fulfilled, the promise is fulfilled, this method gets called, and it has only one argument, and that argument is called value. That is the information you receive from that promise. The second argument is very similar. It's called onReject. And again, it gets called once the promise is rejected, and it receives one value, which we call a reason. One of those two methods will get called eventually, but never both of them. That is important. Sometimes anything which has this then method, that means a method that accepts these two arguments, is called thenable. And in JavaScript and in some other libraries, they can work with these. So it doesn't have to be an instance of a built-in object called promise, but it can be a simple object with just that method. I have a question for you. What is the best analogy, the real world analogy that works for you or for your colleagues to explain promises, how they work? Let me know about that in the comments. So now I hope you have a basic understanding of promises and their states. And I know this hasn't been especially exciting and there is so much more to cover, but this is the baseline we have to get so we can talk about promises in the future. So in the next video, I will be talking about chaining, which is one of the most exciting things in promises. And then I have some patterns I would like to share with you, which simplify my code and make my code more maintainable. So if you don't want to miss that, subscribe to my channel. My name is Robin and I like to write JavaScript. See you next time.